यशोदानन्दन व्रज जनरञ्जन यशोदानन्दन व्रज जनरञ्जन यमुना तीरा वनचारि यमुना तीरा वनचारि
Okay, so we're talking about the glories of the month of Kartik. 今天我们来讲卡尔提卡月的荣耀。在所有的月份中，卡尔提卡月是最荣耀的，因为每一天都是非常美妙的。
One of the first festivals which takes place during this month is the day of the appearance of Radha Kund.
在这一天之中，有一个特别吉祥的日子，就是 Radha Kund 的显现日。
Radha Kund appears at midnight.
Radha Kund 是在半夜显现的。所有文达文的居民以及马图尔的居民，他们都会去到Radha Kund。在半夜的时候，他们都会去那里沐浴。Radha Kund 那里会聚集很多的人。在那之后有一个节日叫巴胡马斯米。哦，这个巴胡马斯米，这个就是 Radha Kund 的显现日的一个别称。
And then there's a festival also Diwali, the festival of Diwali. Literally, the meaning is the festival of lights.
还有一个节日叫 Diwali， 这个节日Diwali 的意思就是灯的节日。
And that's actually the day when Lord Brahma finished the 14 years of exile in the forest and he came back to Ayodhya.
关于这个节日的一个故事就是主 Ramachandra 在森林流放了14年之后回到他的城市。
Yeah, it's not a story, it's history.
这是历史，不是故事。
And then there's another festival, which is called, which we all like very much, Govardhan Puja.
还有一个我们大家都非常喜爱的节日，就是 Govardhan Puja.
The day in which Lord Krishna picked up the Govardhan Hill.
这个就是主 Krishna 举起了哥尔瓦丹山。
And held it up for 7 days and nights.
在那里上演了七天七夜的逍遥时光。
And then there's another festival. There's a festival, the day in which Yamaraj met with his sister. The sister of Yamaraj is Yamuna.
还有一个节日就是 Yamaraj 会见他的妹妹 Yamuna Devi.
So in India, the people celebrate that festival as the relationship between brothers and sisters.
印度人们庆祝这个节日是为了重阳。兄妹之间的感情。
The brothers, the sisters will all look to the brother for shelter.
妹妹总希望能够得到哥哥的庇护。
And they will tie a thing on the wrist of the brother.
他们会在哥哥的这个手上绑上一个绳子。
You'll see fancy decorations and threads and different decorated ornaments put on the wrist of the brother.
会看到他们在兄长的这个手上有各种各样的装饰，绑着各种各样的东西。
And then there's also the festival of Gopashtami, which is the day when Krishna started taking care of cows and not just calves.
还有一个节日叫 Gopashtami， 那天是 Krishna 不仅仅在放这个小牛犊了，开始放真正的牛呢，奶牛。
When Krishna is a young boy, he's taking care of the calves.
当 Krishna 还是一个小孩子的时候，他只是照顾这些小牛犊。
But when he gets a little, when he comes to the age of 10, then he starts, you know, it's 11 actually, it must be 11, right? But from the age of 5 up to 10, that is Boganda.
在5到10岁的时候叫 Boganda， 在5岁之前叫做 Kumar， Boganda 是六到十一岁。
And then 11 to 16 is the age Kishore.
在十一岁到十六岁叫 Kishore。
So when Krishna is 11 years old, then he starts taking care of the cow.
当 Krishna 在十一岁的时候，主 Krishna 就开始照顾奶牛。
That's when Lord Vishnu wakes up, because during the Kartik, during the Chaturmasya, they say Lord Vishnu is taking rest.
在 Kartika 月结束之后，主 Vishnu 就醒来了，因为我们说在 Kartika 月的这一个期间，主 Vishnu 是在休息的。
So they were telling Haridas Thakur that he shouldn't chant so loudly because he would wake up Lord Vishnu.
他们告诉哈尔达斯塔库，你不要唱得太大声，这样就容易把主威士努给吵醒。他如果醒了的话会生气。如果主威士怒醒了的话，这个农民他不会有很好的收成。如果农民不会有很好的收成的话，我们的大餐就不会很好的进行。当然在 Kartika 月，主 Krishna 还会跳 Rasa 之舞，在 Shrad Purnima 期间，主 Krishna 就开始跳舞。
And on the Kartik Purnima, on the full moon day of Kartik, that's the day when the Lord Vishnu avatars in the form of Matsya avatar, the fish.
在 Kartika Purnima, 就是 Kartika 的满月那一天，主 Vishnu 会变成 Matsya avatar。Matsya Avatar 他就是从恶魔那里拯救了韦达金。在那个时候发生了洪水，所有的圣哲做了一个祈求，他们安排了 Matsya Avatar 的显现来拯救韦达金。
And it was also on this Purnima, on the full moon day, Lord Shiva killed the demon Tripurasura.
在满月 Kartika 满月的那一天，主 Shiva 杀了恶魔 Gude 那个名 Tripurasura。
And also Vrinda Devi, who's the manager of Vrindavan. Vrinda Devi also celebrates her appearance day on that Purnima.
Vrinda Devi, 也就是Vrindavan 的掌管者，他也在那一天庆祝了他的显现。
During the Kartik, when Tulsi Shaligram, that she celebrates her bond, there's a marriage between Tulsi and Shaligram. So that takes place during the month of Kartik.
在 Kartika 月期间 ，Shaligram 和 Tulsi， 也就是在这个月期间，他们有一个结婚的仪式。
But there's something special about Kartik, and something special is that there's one festival which is celebrated every day for the month of Kartik.
有一个在 Kartika 月很特别的节日，就是每一天都会举办的一个节日。
All the other festivals, they're only celebrating one day.
所有其他的节日只是庆祝一天而已。
But this one festival is celebrated every day of the month.
但是这个节日在这一个月每一天都庆祝。所以我们可以理解这是一个非常特别的节日。你们认为这个节日是什么呢？供灯，对。我们向谁供灯呢？我们每一天我们都在通过供灯的方式崇拜主达玛达尔。所有刚刚我们前面提到的其他的节日只是庆祝一天，但是这个供灯我们是每一天都在进行的一个节日。在这一个月的每一天都会有不同的神像来掌管主的，不同的神像掌管。而掌管这个月的这个神就是Srimati Radharani。Srimati Radharani 的另外一个名字就是 Kartik。在所有的牧牛姑娘之中， Srimati Radharani 对主 Krishna 最为亲切。在这个月之中，人们应该崇拜 Srimati Radharani 和就是和主 Damodar 在一起进行崇拜。Kartika 月被称为一整年之中最为重要的一个月，是最为虔诚的，是最为净化的，是一整年之中最为吉祥的月份。在所有的年代之中， Satya Yoga 是最好的。在所有的书籍之中，韦达经是最好的。没有比冈嘎更好的圣地。没有其他的月份能够和卡尔提卡月比肩。所有的 Vaishnava 都认为 Kartika 月对于主 Krishna 最为亲切。在所有的月份之中， Kartika 月对于主 Krishna 最为亲近。在 Sanatana Goswami 的 Hari Bhakti Vilas 这里面写到，任何人在这个月向主 Krishna 哪怕供奉一丁点的东西，都会能够得到在 Krishna 的居所的居民的身份。Jiva Goswami 告诉我们一个美妙的故事。这个故事被描述在 Ganga Purana 之中。 这个故事向我们展示的是，即便在这个月你做了一丁点的崇拜，你都能够得到非常巨大的获益。
So this story is also quoted by Sanatana Goswami in his commentary, in his Digdarshana Tika, which is one of the books written by Sanatana Goswami.
这个故事也被 Sanatana Goswami 收录在 Digdarshan Dina 这本书里面。
And this story tells us how Krishna is so eager for us to, he's so eager to receive our worship.
在这个故事也向我们展示了主 Krishna 他是多么渴望从我们这里接受，他希望从我们这里获得我们对他的崇拜。
And if he just sees a little devotion in someone, Krishna gives so much in return.
即便我们给出非常非常微小的一点点服务，他都会给予我们非常永恒的回报。
So you should understand that this is a very special story.
这是一个非常特别的故事。当然我们也不能模仿，我们应该欣赏主 Krishna 他是多么的仁慈。
So there was this one king, and he had 150 sons.
有一个国王，他有150个儿子。
And he had one daughter.
他有一个女儿。
And the daughter's name was Lalitika.
他的女儿的名字叫 Lalitika.
So the king gave her in marriage to the king of Kasi.
国王把这个女儿嫁给了 Kasi 国王。
Now the king of Kasi had 300 wives.
但是 Kasik 这个国王他有300个妻子，但是他却最喜欢这个 Lalitika， 他是一个原则最有原则的王后，最主要的王后。她非常有奉爱，而且非常美丽。非常美丽，也非常履行职责。也非就是她履行职责和她的美丽是一样的。
She was not only beautiful externally.But internally, her heart was also very beautiful.
她不仅外在非常美丽，她的内心也非常的美丽。
So this girl, this queen, Lalitika, she undertook an unusual vow during the month of Kartika.
这个王后她在 Kartika 月做了一个非常不寻常的誓言。
You know what she did? She would light thousands of lamps all over the temples of Lord Vishnu.
她在你们知道她做了什么样的活动吗？她在这一个月供奉上千盏灯给主 Vishnu.
So, but she didn't only put lamps in the temple of Vishnu. She went to the homes of the Brahmanas and she put lights there.
他不仅仅是到庙宇里面去供奉这个上千盏灯，他还去婆罗门的家里面。
And wherever there were mountains, she put lights on the top of the mountains.
而且无论哪里有山，他都到那个山峰上去供奉这个灯。
And she put lamps all along the side of the river.
他还会把灯供奉在所有河的岸边。
And even she put lamps on the surface of wells.
Well.
水井
啊，水井哦，他还会把这个灯放到水井的旁边。
So everyone was astonished to see how many lights she put everywhere.
每个人都能看到他，就是他的灯到处都供奉着。他在每一天，这一个月的每一天都供奉这么多的灯。人们非常好奇他为什么要这么做呢？因为要把这些灯放到不同的所有的这些地方是比较复杂和麻烦的一件事。所以人们就会问他，请告诉我您为什么要这么做呢？他笑了一下，笑了一笑，对人们说：“他说这是他向主表达他的感激之情。”因为他向主，他从主那里得到了太多的仁慈，他想通过这种方式来表达他对主的感恩。
So then she explained to them what happened. They heard how in her previous life she had been a mouse.
在他前一世，他曾经是一个老鼠。
But by the grace of the Lord, she had taken birth. Now she becomes
But she is born in such a royal family. She's a queen, and she has so much opulence, and she's so beautiful, and she knows it's all due to the mercy of the Lord. But she is born in such a royal family.而且还嫁给了一个国王，他知道所有的这一切都是主的仁慈。
So, she explained what happened that as a mouse, she was living in the corner of a temple.
当他还是一个老鼠的时候，就是前一世的时候，他是一个老鼠的时候，他在庙宇的一个角落。
And people.
他看到人们来到庙宇里面会供奉一些灯。
So the mouse was very, very hungry. She explains it that when I was in the body of the mouse, a little mouse, I couldn't get anything to eat. I was very hungry.
他说，当我还在这个老鼠的身体里的时候，我非常的饥饿，我得不到任何的食物，我想非常饿。
And I saw this wick.
我看到这个酥油灯的这个酥油在棉花里面燃烧着。于是他就去吃那个沾满着酥油的棉花，因为这个里面有酥油，他就去吃这个。他吃到这个酥油非常的美味。
But suddenly a cat appeared.
突然一只猫出现了。
And when the mouse saw the cat, then of course the cat is the enemy of the mouse. Mouse was terrified.
当猫出现了之后，老鼠就非常的害怕，因为他们是天敌。
But at the same time, mouse was eating this cotton wick.And the cotton wick was burning on the other end. It was on fire.
但是与此同时，这个老鼠又在吃这个燃烧着的棉花，棉花芯就是灯芯。
So the mouse ran to save his life. The mouse ran to save its life. But it was taken, the mouse took the keyway with it.
这个老鼠就开始疯狂的逃跑，它同时还带着这个灯芯。他一边跑还一边不想放弃这个灯芯，这个灯芯还点燃着，还是燃烧着的。然后这个老鼠就也自己被点燃了起来。
The mouse was burning.
老鼠就这个老鼠就由此而被燃烧了起来。有火焰身上。
And the mouse was right there in the temple in front of the deity.
他甚至当时都刚好就跑到了神像的面前。
And this happened to be on the Ekadasi day in the month of Kartik.
刚好那一天是阿卡达西，就是卡尔提卡月里面的阿尔克达西那一天，艾克达西那一天。
And the mouse is on fire. So the mouse was dancing, jumping up and down.
老鼠当时身上已经被点燃了，所以他当时热的就开始跳脚啊，就开始跳舞了。他当时跳起来就像在跳舞一样。所有的这一切都在神像面前跳着。以这种方式，这个老鼠离开了他的躯体。
But because he gave up his body in that way, the deity saw this mouse, the Lord Krishna in the form of the deity thought, this mouse is dancing for me.
但是虽然老鼠是这么样离开去，但是神像他不这么认为，他认为这个老鼠是在朝着我跳舞。因为老鼠是这样的方式离开躯体，所以主 Krishna 给予他下一生很不一样的安排。
Very, very beautiful, very wealthy, and very devoted.
既美丽又富裕，而且又充满着奉爱。
So this is how this Lalitika became the queen.
这就描述了这个纳尼提卡她是如何成为一个王后的。在她前一世她是一个老鼠，但是这一世她成为了一个王后。
So she was appreciating how just by offer that one offering which was done without even without her intention of offering anything to Krishna brought her so much benefit.
在他前一世，他虽然不是有意的去做这样的一个供奉，但是即便是这样的一种情况，却给他带来了巨大的好处。因此他是这么想的，如果我在老鼠的那个躯体里面做了这么一点点供奉都这样，那我应该在这一世有这么好的条件情况下，我应该做更多的服务。
She understood the importance of the month of Kartik.
他知道在卡尔提卡月这一天的重要性。因为他在老鼠的那个躯体里面，他就做了那么一天的这个情况，但是他在现在这个躯体里面，他每一天都这么做。
So she's encouraging us that we should also understand the importance of having good habits.
她的这个故事也告诉我们，我们应该在这个月有一个非常好的习惯。
Habits are very important. You know, we have good habits and we have bad habits.
习惯非常重要，我们有好的习惯，也有坏的习惯。
Maybe bad habits like, you know, we overeat or we oversleep.
坏的习惯包括，比如说我们吃的过多或者睡的过多。
Or we're lazy.
或者说我们非常懒惰。
We have bad habits. Some people bad habits is smoking, drinking.
这些都是坏的习惯，还有一些人的坏的习惯是吃这个肉或者说抽烟。
But we can have also good habits.
我们也可以拥有一些好的习惯。
Good habits are like waking up early in the morning.
好的习惯包括早上早起。
Go to Mangalarti.
去参加 Mangalarti.
Chanting Japa every day.
每一天念诵 Japa.
Hearing the scriptures.
聆听经典。
These are all good habits.
这些都是非常好的习惯。
So to develop a habit, you have to do something for a number of days. It's not you can just do it one time and you have a habit.
你想拥有一个好的习惯，不是说你只做一天这样的事情就可以了，你得每一天都这么去做。
So this month of Kartik is an opportunity for us to develop some good habits.
这个卡尔提卡月就是给我们一个机会，让我们拥有一个很好的习惯。
Just like offering the lamp to Lord Dhamma.
就像在这一天我们供奉这个灯给主达摩达尔。
So we have to develop the habit, then after Kartik, we will continue. We want to offer a lamp to the Lord.
在这个月我们供奉主给主灯，我们在这之后我们也应该有愿望去给主供灯。
We should think, why will we do it in the month of Kartik? We should do it every day.
我们不应该想我们只在这一个月做，我们应该想为什么我们不每一天都这么去做呢？
So of course, we offer Arti, we offer the lamp, this is the Arti.
当然我们在我们的 Arti 之中我们也会给主供奉灯。
And so we want to develop these kind of habits to help us to engage more in devotional sense.
我们希望通过这样的一个好培养一个好的习惯来增进我们的奉爱服务。
So we can see from that example about this wonderful girl, Lalitika, how even in the body of the mouth, she got so much benefit for the service of.
我们通过学习这个故事了解到这个拉提卡他在他前一世是一个老鼠的躯体里面就做了这么一丁点的服务。
So we try to take advantage of this month of Damodar to introduce Krishna consciousness to more people.
我们也利用这个卡尔提卡月去充分利用这个卡尔提卡月去把主 Krishna 介绍给更多的人。
People have that custom to have lights. They like lamps. They like lamps. We always feel uncomfortable in the darkness.
其实人们也有这样的一个习惯，他喜欢在晚上的时候点一个灯，他们觉得在晚上的时候非常害怕。
We want to feel more the value of light, offering the lamp to the Lord.
我们给这个点灯的这个事情赋予更多的价值，更多更有意义的事情，把这个灯供奉给主。
Yeah, the light is signifying knowledge. Darkness is ignorance.
黑暗和光明象征着这一个愚昧和知识。
So when we offer the light to the Lord, we're also praying to the Lord, please enlighten us.Make my heart also clear that I can also see you.
当我们点完点这个灯的时候，我们也是向主祈祷，能够希望主启明我们的内心，能够更多的了解你。
We know Krishna is in the heart, but he's covered. The heart is covered.
Krishna 在我们的内心，但是却被我们的内心给覆盖着。
So we want to remove that darkness from our heart.
我们希望驱除我们内心的黑暗。
So when we offer the light, we are praying to Lord Krishna that we can also clean our heart, we can see him.
我们向主供奉这个灯的时候，我们也向主祈祷，希望能主能够驱走我们内心的黑暗和愚昧，能够看见他。
So, we have this festival during this habit, during the month of Karti. You can see many people, more people coming to the temple, coming to attend the program during this month. They develop that habit.
Sorry, 哥哥，我把这个话筒调一下。
People develop the habit to come to temple.
在这一个月，人们都会有这样的一个习惯，会到庙宇里面去。
And if they start to come during the month of Karti, then of course they'll keep some of these habits. They'll stay with them throughout the rest of the year.
如果他们能够在这个月坚持去庙里面的话，sorry.
The habits which they develop in the month of Kartik will stay with them for the rest of the year.
如果他们能够在 Kartika 月发展出这样的习惯化，这样的习惯会伴随着其他剩下的这个年份。
So, in this way, people can learn to devote their life for the service of the Lord.
这样人们就可以，学到更多关于奉爱的。给予主的奉爱。
Everything is depending on our habits, the things we do, what we become accustomed to do.
无论我们做一些什么事情，都取决于我们的习惯。
Some people have the habit, they have to drink tea.
有一些人他有这个喝茶的习惯。
Some people have the habit, they have to spit.
还有一些人有吐口水的习惯。
People have the habit to use bad language, dirty language.
还有一些人喜欢说脏话的习惯。
We have to learn to cultivate good habits.
我们希望培养出好的习惯。
To speak about Krishna.
应该去谈论主 Krishna.
And we have the habit when we cook, we offer everything to Krishna.
我们有好的习惯，我们烹饪一切都是为了主 Krishna.
So for many people.
对于大多数人而言，他们向主供奉的第一个事情可以是这个灯。我们看到很多人，他来到庙宇，他希望给主供奉一些东西。他们也希望给主供奉的一些灯，我们就把灯给他，让他给主供灯。
So this is the beginning of their devotional service.
这就是他们奉爱服务的开始。
So we hope they can also go on to develop more these habits.
我们也希望他们能够在这个奉献服务的道路上继续下去。好，请问大家有什么问题吗？
或者您刚才讲的那个，就是，神像误以为那个老鼠是在下面供奉，那个亏他的每个生物体的心里，他都会把这个事给分错。
The deity think the mouse is offering offering a dance for him, but the deity also in our heart. How the deity can misunderstanding about this? It's okay.
The mouse, actually, the intention of the mouse is not offering his dance to the Lord Vishnu, but then the Lord Vishnu took it as an offering of his dance. So he's thinking the Lord is inside our hearts as super soul. He would understand our real intentions.How can the deity make such a mistake?
Well, it's not a mistake, but it's the kindness of Lord Krishna.
这不是一个误解，不是一个误会，而是主 Krishna 的仁慈。
Just like Putana, You know, Putana was a witch, and she came with poison to offer her breast to Krishna. And in order to come in there into Nanda Maharaj's house, Putana disguised herself like a gopi.
为了去到 Nanda Maharaj 的家里， Putana 把自己打扮成一个 gopi。Putana 想过去去杀 Krishna， 他把这个主 Krishna 抱起来给他喂奶，主 Krishna 最后把 Putana 杀了，然后 把这个 Putana 带回了灵性世界。这是主 Krishna 给予他的特别的仁慈。在这里我们也看到这样的小老鼠的例子，它是如何得到的主的仁慈，在下一生有一个更好的机会。但这是主的仁慈。这个老鼠是如此的幸运，它住在了庙里，然后它还竟然吃了是这个灯上面的油灯的灯芯里面的酥油。这个老鼠也是有一个非常好的业报的，它住在了庙里面，他吃的是这个酥油灯的酥油。他身体燃烧的那一天是在 Kartika 月最吉，就是最吉祥的月份里面最吉祥的一天， Kartika 月里面的 Ekadashi。这个老鼠当时还在神像面前跳舞，这是非常特别的。所以 Krishna 也给予他特别的回报。
Depends on your devotion. You can offer to the deity at the same time, but in your mind you can understand that Damodar is just a form, another form of the deity.
这个取决于你的奉爱。其实主达摩达尔也是这个主的另外的一个形象。
Krishna comes in many different forms.
主 Krishna 来到这里是以各种不同的形象。你或许是在向其他的神像进行形象的神像进行崇拜，但是你内心也许想的是主达摩达尔。当我们在供奉这个灯唱诵这个歌的时候，达摩达尔斯塔肯这歌的时候，我们是在记忆主 Krishna 的这个所有的这个逍遥时光在这一个月。
So it all depends on the attitude of the devotee.
一切都取决于奉献者的态度心态。
所有的经典都描述像达摩达尔做服务有什么功德，还有什么做噶尔丹那山 班呢也有很多很多功德，还有供奉牛啊什么的，是描述了好多这样的功德，就是奉献者做服务的时候是不求回报的，但是这个经典上都是描述做这个有回报，回报这是一个就是说功利性活动和纯粹的奉献服务，我有点混淆分不清该怎么去理解这个问题。
Well, yeah, what's devotional service and what's karma kanda? It's going to depend also again it's the attitude of the devotee.
无论是 karma kanda 也好，还是说奉献服务，纯粹奉献服务也好，取决于这个做的人他的心态。
It's not simply the activity, but it's the mood in which we perform the activity.
不仅仅是我们做的这些活动，而是我们在做这些活动时候的心态。
Generally, however, karma kanda activities are worship of the demigods.
通常来讲 ，karma kanda 就是业报之部的这个活动，它讲的是崇拜半神人。
Yeah, they worship demigods for specific purposes.
他们崇拜半神人是以各种不同的目的，带着不同的目的去崇拜的。
Worship Lord Krishna or Lord Vishnu, then you're coming into the. It's not so much that there's not so much that it's special because Lord Krishna he doesn't give results very quickly. That's why people don't worship him so much.
但是崇拜主 Krishna。主 Krishna 有个特别，就是他不会立刻的给予你一个某一样的回报，所以人们通常不太喜欢崇拜主 Krishna 为什么？
People worship the demigods because they get results quickly.
人们喜欢崇拜半神人，是因为他们能够从半神人那里迅速的得到回报。
But in the worship of Lord Vishnu or Lord Krishna, Lord Krishna is very concerned. He thinks about it very carefully before he fulfills anyone's desire.
但是在崇拜主 Vishnu 或主 Krishna 的时候，主 Krishna 会思考，他会如何这个回报对你到底是一个怎么样的好处，他会慢慢的思考一下。
He's not going to just immediately give our material desires.
主也不会立刻的就去满足你的物质的愿望。
If he knows something is not going to be good for us, then he won't give it.
如果主认为这个事情对于我们并不好，他不会给予我们。
He wants to bring us out of the material world. He wants to bring us back to God.
他希望能够把我们带离到这个物质世界之外，能够把我们带回守神身边。
That's why we're encouraged to worship Krishna or Vishnu. Don't worship other gods.
这也是我们被推荐崇拜主 Vishnu 和 Krishna 的原因，而不去崇拜半神人的原因。
So even you have material desires, you can worship the Lord.
即便你有物质的愿望，你也可以去崇拜主。
It's not karma kanda, but it's karma mishra bhakti. It's devotion mixed with material desire.
这个不是 karma kanda, 就是你带着物质的愿望。去崇拜主，这个是 karma mishra bhakti， 就是说 karma 你就是 bhakti 奉爱，你在做奉爱的活动中混合了一些物质的动机你在里面。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes how four kinds of people come to him.
在《博迦梵歌》中，主 Krishna 描述了四种人去接近主 Krishna。
Right, and one comes in distress.
一种是非常痛苦的人，还有追求财富的人，非常好奇好问的人，还有追求知识的人。Dhruva Maharaj 他希望能够得到一个巨大的王国，他去到森林里面做了很多的苦行，然后见到了主。
Lord Vishnu appeared to him.
主维什努显现给他。
And gave him his material desire.
也满足了他的物质的愿望。
But Dhruva Maharaj said he didn't want his material desire.
但是 Dhruva Maharaj 说他并不想要这些物质愿望。
But Lord Vishnu said, no, you did. You asked for it in the beginning. Now you have to take it.
但是主威士诺说在开始的时候你想要了，你渴求了，所以你现在就得接受。
So Dhruva Maharaj had to take a position in the material world.
所以 Dhruva Maharaj 在物质世界接受了一个职位，在接受了一个他的位置。
Before he could go back to God.
在离开，在他回归守神之前，他接受了这样的一个位置。
So we do worship. We do, you do Govardhan Puja. You go around the Govardhan Hill. And there are many people who go around Govardhan Hill. And they don't really know much about what they're doing.
很多人做这个戈巴南普贾，然后去戈巴南山，但是他们并不知道他们在做什么。
I was walking around the Govardhan Hill one day, and I met this one man, and he was telling me, he said, every Purnima, every Ekadasi, I come here and I go around Govardhan Hill.
有一次我在绕拜戈巴南山时候，有一个人就跟我说，他说每一个普尼玛满月，每一个艾克达喜，我都会来这个戈尔巴丹山绕拜。
So I said, "Wow, you must be a great devotee of Lord Krishna."
然后我就跟他说，你肯定是主 Krishna 一个非常伟大的奉献者。
He said, "Yes, not only Krishna, I worship all the gods."
他说，不仅仅是主 Krishna， 我崇拜所有的这些神。
So I understood, you know, he had some different ideas.
所以那一刻我就明白他肯定有一些不同的概念，但是仍然他也来到了戈尔瓦丹山在做这个绕拜。有一些人崇拜主 Krishna， 有一些物质的愿望，他会得到一些好处，他们也在伟大的道路上。
He hears the prayers and he knows their mind.
但是主 Krishna 他知道我们的祈祷，知道我们的内心。
So he makes arrangements for their purification.
他会为他们的净化而做出安排。
Gradually they come to Krishna.
他们会逐渐的到达主 Krishna 那里。We should be very curious about our material desire because it will make us stay in this material world.
Yes, right.
是的。
Yes, that's why we are hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. That's the message of Srimad Bhagavatam.
这也就是 Srimad Bhagavatam 圣典波迦瓦坛传递给我们的信息。我们应该对我们内心的愿望非常的清晰。你到底是想要得到纯粹的奉献服务，到底想不想回到守神的身边？有一些人或许是奉献者，但他并不是特别强烈的想回到守神的身边。
We'd rather come back. Come back again.
所以他们更好就是再一次来到这里。
Just let me be in a good situation that I can enjoy.
然后让我能够拥有一个更好的条件，让我能够享受。
You want to be like Lalitika.
你可以可能我们听完也想变成这个拉利提卡，成为这个王后，想成为王后，又有钱又美丽，你还想要什么
了？
我们看到他其实还没有回归到灵性世界，也没有回到守神的身边，他还是得死亡。
So Jiva Goswami tells the other story about the astrologer who gave blessings to different people.
Jiva Goswami 描述了另外一个故事，就是这个占星家他是如何给予不同的人以祝福的。
So there was a king's son, the prince.
有一个王子。
He was very wealthy.
他非常有钱。
So he was blessed. May you live forever.
于是这个占星家就告诉他，希望你能够永生。
Rajaputra Charanjeeva. Charanjeeva means don't die.
祝福你不要死亡。
Why? Because after he dies, next life you will have vampire.
因为当他一旦死亡之后，在下一生他就会有非常不好的情况。
This life he's very rich.
这一生他非常有钱。
He's enjoying so much sense gratification.
他享受了太多的感官享乐。
When he dies, next life you don't know.
当他离开躯体之后，下一生我们不知道他是一个什么样的境况。
You see, in the Vedic culture, the kings will retire.
在伟达的文化之中，国王他是应该退休的。
They go to the forest, they go study.
当他退休之后，他会去到森林里面去苦行。去能够通过苦行为更好的一生做准备。如果你愿意的话，如果你能够在 Radha Kund 沐浴的时候带着纯粹的奉爱服务、奉爱的心态的话，你应该非常的小心注意这件事。
You have to be very pure and very pure consciousness.
你应该非常有纯粹的、非常纯粹、非常纯粹的知觉。有一些奉献者他是去沐浴的，有一些奉献者他不沐浴的，我们存在着不同的观点。圣帕帕的听到有一些奉献者在河里面玩耍和奉献者嬉戏的时候，他说你们是在
kicking
你是在踢，你是在踢 Radharani， 你并不是在做奉爱服务，你是在踢 Radharani， 这个也不会免除你们罪，
这会造成很多的罪恶反应。
对，这会造成你们很多的罪恶反应。你们应该非常注意你们的知觉，在沐浴的时候。也因此有很多奉献者不在那里沐浴。Sachinanda Swami 他会去沐浴。但我也但我不我知道这个，我认为这个 Govinda Maharaj B.B. Govinda Maharaj 他不会去沐浴。
B.B. Govinda Maharaj when he went there with a group of devotees, they went and they cleaned the whole all the area around Radhakund. They took brooms and buckets and they cleaned and swept the whole area around Radhakund.
他们不仅不去沐浴，而且为 Radha Kun， 他会去清洁整个 Radha Kun 周边的这些垃圾啊，他会去为做这个服务。
Some people also they do dandavats around the Radha Kun。
还有一些人会在 Radha Kun 做 dandava 这个绕拜。
You can also do that。
你也可以去做这个 dandava。
Just like people do dandavats around Govardhan Shan, you can also do the dandavats obeisances all around the Radha Kun。
有一些人他会做 dandava 这个 parikram 绕拜哥尔瓦的山，你也可以去做 dandava parikram 绕拜 Radha Kun。After this month, shall we offer the lamp every day?
Yeah, you can do it.
可以。
加纳卡帕布问，前进的顶拜圣库尔德，请问达摩达是在哪个年龄段？是苦玛尔年龄段吗？
主达摩达 in which period of his age?
苦玛尔。
库玛尔年龄。在库玛尔年龄阶段。
然后还有，顶拜您咕噜队，我是昨天刚刚托庇您的佳木斯的王云平，我想问为什么要在达摩达尔月天天路灯？另外一个问题。
Why we should offer the lamp every day? This is the first part.
We are offering worship to the Lord. It's a form of worship.
这是崇拜主的一种方式。
Just like when a great personality comes to your home, sometimes you will offer a light and we will offer a lamp to welcome them into the home.
就像有一些伟大的人物去到你家里的时候，我们也会给他供灯一样。同样的，我们在做 Arti 的时候也会供奉灯。这个供灯是崇拜主的一种形式，我们通过供奉这个灯来崇拜主达摩达。The second part is, shall we, yes.
If we give money to somebody, can we get the benefit? We give money to someone to make the offering on our behalf. So will we get the same benefit? No.
不，我们把钱给予别人，让别人带着我们供灯，这个没有得到同样的好处，这个好处不是同样的。
一名爬坡问，经典上说，在卡提克月，我们只给主供奉一盏灯就可以达到完美，那意思就是，那就不用学巴托塔了，就不用念词了，学了其他都不用做。
If we can get everything by offering a lamp to the Lord, why do we bother to study Srimad Bhagavatam? Yes, but you're not just offering a lamp to the Lord, you're doing a lot of other things as well. You're engaging in so many other activities. It's not that you're just only offering one lamp to the Lord.You engage in so many activities, material activities. You have a lot of karma. The girl in the body of the mouse became the princess. You didn't go back to Godhead. You just want to become a queen, or do you want to go back to Godhead? We're trying to go back to Godhead. We don't just want to become a queen.
当这个前面我们讲的这个故事之历史的故事之中，这个老鼠他做了这样的一个服务，成为了一个王后。但是呢，我们的目的不是说想成为这个一个王后，我们的目的是要回归守神。我们供奉这个灯，我们平时还会做其他的很多的 物质上的一些活动，因此我们不应该仅仅只是供奉一盏灯，我们还要做其他的活动，是为了我们能够回归守神，而不是仅仅只成为一个王后而已。
就像我们都有这么多物质愿望啊，我们天天都在念诵在什么，这个问题我有的时候有点纠结。
She said if we have a tiny material desire, don't bother the Krishna. So we have so much material desire, how we also chant, how can we understand this?
Well,we're in a purifying stage. It takes some time to go through the purification.
在进化的阶段，我们是需要一些时间才能获得进化的。
The material desires are there, but gradually they become less and less.
在这个进化阶段，我们的物质的愿望是逐渐的减少的。
The more we hear and chant.
我们更多的聆听唱诵做奉献服务，我们就会得到越少的物质愿望。
Just like the fan doesn't stop immediately, it still has some momentum even after we turn off the power, still the fan goes round a little bit.
就像我们把电风扇的电源关掉，这个电扇不会立马就停下来，它会持续转一段时间。
So in the same way, our material desires, while we still have material desires, they're gradually being reduced because we're changing the desire. We're beginning to desire more for Krishna. And we're desiring more for Krishna's service, so the material desires are minimized.
同样的，我们在做奉献服务，我们物质愿望不仅减少，而且我们在改变这个物质愿望，我们把物质愿望转变成为主 Krishna 做服务的这种愿望。
We cannot stop desire.
我们也无法停止我们的愿望。
We want to purify the desire.
我们希望净化我们的愿望。
So we have to develop more desire for the service of Krishna.
我们发展出更多的愿望去为主 Krishna 做奉献服务。聆听唱诵，这样物质的愿望就会被击败。
Darkness can never conquer light.
黑暗是无法战胜光明的。
As soon as the sun comes up, all the darkness is gone.
当太阳升起来的时候，所有的黑暗就会消失殆尽。
Where there is Krishna, there can be no Maya.
哪里有主 Krishna, 哪里就没有 Maya。如果我们有更多的愿望去服务主 Krishna， 我们就会有更少的愿望去，就是越来越少的愿望想去服务 Maya。 好，Jai Hare Krishna. Jai.